just a few paces away from the main outpatient department at the Tafu Government Hospital, one could hear the cry of little Umo Ayman. The two-year-old is reluctant to undergo her regular physiotherapy treatment. Not even the mother could understand why her daughter is avoiding today's treatment. Umo cries incessantly. Physiotherapist in charge Edu Solomon Nogate says it is a pain she is going through. She has been suffering from Epps palsy disease. Health experts say the condition might have occurred during delivery when her neck was overstretched. Umo and her mother Fati Kazim have been visiting the physiotherapy unit of the hospital for the past 2 months.
Nanso ama edumayefo no so mo ndo so sa nti wo ba o mo nya chance emma entreat akwara ni ye nti o mo forces the way akwara no o mo treat na o banya no ho SIR sa.
Specialists attend to them twice a week with high optimism. Little Umo would overcome her condition and get better soon. But lack of special equipment is impeding the best of care at the facility.
You need to fill the department with the equipment, the necessary equipment that are meant for physiotherapy purposes.
The hospital says it is being compelled to treat patients under a very difficult condition. The unit space is a small corridor under a size of a standard single bedroom with a few equipment, while the rest of the space accommodates patients.
As you can see the place, we don't have enough space. But then whatever physio related case that comes here, we are able to manage and then discharge the person successfully. In fact, we need the space badly so that we can continue to help our patients achieve their goals whenever they come here.
Since its establishment in 2015, Mr. Nogate and his colleagues who started the unit have made little headway in strengthening their resolve to attend to more patients a day. For now, the unit attends at least to 18 cases daily, and several others are advised to seek care elsewhere.
We've been able to acquire some basic equipment for the physiotherapy.
Dr. Kwame Ajiman is the medical superintendent of the hospital.
The inadequate equipment, or let's say the gadgets that the physiotherapist needs to treat the patient, we also don't have the space. If you go and have a look at the physiotherapy unit, it's just a small corridor which we have improvised as a physiotherapy unit, which is really, unacceptable. But then we have to do with it because we don't have any other alternative.
Inadequate spacing cut across all the unit at the facility.
But if you go and have a look at our general ward, it's just about 3 rooms which we are using. One room for the female patients, one for the male, and one also for the children. In fact, the maximum bed capacity at the general ward is about 25 and not more. So you can just imagine that the more people turn up here, we are forced to refer some to a Kompanochi because we don't have the space to take care of them. The same thing too applies to the psychiatry unit. We don't have any proper infrastructure to house them. So what we are using currently now is our library, which has been converted into the psychiatry, consultation rooms. And that's, for God's sake, is also very inappropriate.
Unfortunately, a project which was supposed to reduce the pressure at the hospital has been abandoned. Several appeals by hospital's authorities to get it completed have yielded no positive results.
And that is why we've been appealing since 2 years ago to the government that we have an uncompleted maternity block which was started during the tenure of President Jay Kufuor, and which has been neglected, or let me say abandoned since then. And this building we are talking about is about 70-80% completed. But we've been appealing to the government through various media houses. But as we are talking now, no action has been taken for the commencement of the continuation of the project.
A report by Mahmoud Mohammed Nuruddin.